Hey everybody, it's Sinvicta, and let's keep the, I guess, Never Give Up, Never Surrender Priest deck rocking and rolling. Thank you everybody who's been watching the run thus far, and of course, welcome to all my new subscribers here who've been sent by my good friend Husky Starcraft, as well as other of my friends who I collaborate with, and we're just going to keep on rolling with it. We're currently 2-2 after I preemptively called 0-3 to the wonky priest deck. But Never Give Up, Never Surrender, we definitely had a fight for us in that last game, and everything went our way. So it does look like it's going to be a mirror match. Will this go the way of the first game? I don't know. And Malagos is not a card that I want to see at the beginning stages here. Neither is the Twilight Drake, so we'll go ahead and politely get rid of both of those. Divine Spirit, Mass Dispel come out, and that is a heck of a card. If we get an Inner Fire, we can slam dunk this super duper early. As Divine Spirit, Powered Shield plus Divine Spirit turns the Northshire Cleric into a 10-10 on turn 3 if you do indeed get the Inner Fire draw. So we'll have to wait and see. Now, of course, she is very susceptible early on with the low attack to priests such as Shadow Ward Pain, which kills all minions below 2, I believe. It executes everything. She can't be smited to death unless there's a Spell Power minion out there. So we do get Mind Control, not what we're looking for. Let's go ahead and get the Northshire Cleric just to have a little bit of board presence. And will she survive before we draw an Inner Fire? I think we have 3 Inner Fires in this deck, which is pretty funny. Mana Wraith comes out, which is going to hurt our ability to summon minions, but all is not lost because we can still do damage to it. Heal up our Cleric, get a free card draw out of it. And look who's back, the Twilight Drake. Not the card that I wanted to see. And of course, now the Priest can still heal the Mana Wraith as well, but that would be a little bit silly because I'm just going to keep throwing my Northshire Cleric into the Mana Wraith, and that will also keep giving me cards as well. So no, he's going to actually smite. So, okay. Inner Fire comes out. Unfortunately, we did lose our... Northshire Cleric, so there's not much we can really do about this right now. I could turn that into a 1-1, but I have no way of really killing it. This may be a little bit wasteful here, but what I'm going to do is I am going to Mass Dispel and silence the Mana Wraith just because I do not want to suffer that minion cost penalty anymore. And you may also see where I'm going with this, especially now, even though I've talked junk about this card before, we are set up very nicely. We've got 2, 4, 6, 8 cards in our hand, and this Twilight Drake is about to get the absolute hell silenced out of it. And here come the Northshire Clerics. So a Novice Engineer comes out, and that is not what we need. But go big or go home. Here comes the Twilight Drake. And will the Twilight Drake live to the next round? For our opponent's sake, let's hope not. But for our sake, let's hope he does indeed live. And I don't know why he healed that, because that's not how the card works. But I'm just gonna pretend I didn't see that, I guess.
Not quite what was... My apologies.
Yeah, that was pretty funny there, Spin. I'll go ahead and give you an emote response on that. But he's not going to be able to kill the Twilight Drake, and this is going to be really, really bad. So bad, we can't actually end the game yet. I know, as crazy as that sounds, oh boy. Get ready for this one, nerds. Actually, we can end the game. The game's over. The game is actually over because we can double it twice. Give it 36, 36, and slam dunk it. Oh, my God. Oh, my Lord. A turn 5, 36, 36. Wow. That was brutal.